The only people who don't want to disclose the truth are people with something to hide.
Hello, YouTube. Sorry I ain't gave you no updates yet, but here's all I got so far. Didn't have no computer today. I couldn't do no research, so I'm at home now. But I didn't have no, having a little computer issues at work there, so didn't get to use my computer much today. But here's the update I got so far, and maybe I'll have some more here in a minute. I'm gonna pause this and add a clip into it, another one here in a minute. I've got to follow some of these links, so hang in there. Well, everybody, here's some more, but I think this is just some more of the same propaganda they popping out there. Yeah, it is. It's just the same old thing here. I'm still looking, though. I'll leave this in here for other people that hadn't read it, so hang in there. Well, everybody, it just gets stranger and stranger. You can see what it says here. I'm going to leave it up for a second. Still looking for the other stuff too, but as you can see, it just gets worse and worse. I'm still looking though, folks. Hang in there. Well, everybody, I ain't found anything else as of yet. Evidently, they haven't had to vote yet or whatever. But here's another interesting article that I found. It's building up, like Linda LaRouche said yesterday on Alex Jones's channel. So I'm letting you read that, and we're gonna go back up here to the top here in just a second. We're gonna listen to this together because I haven't heard it either. So hold on just a second. Let me get it ready.
11月21号，美国、英国和加拿大宣布对伊朗采取更多的制裁措施，法国也提出采取新的制裁措施，以迫使德黑兰停止核专案。23号，中共外交部发言人在北京举行的例行新闻发布会上说，中方反对针对伊朗的单边制裁。学者认为，受到孤立的中共和伊朗需要相互支援。
路透社23号报道说，美国、英国和加拿大宣布对伊朗能源和金融业实行新的制裁，法国则提议实行前所未有的新制裁，其中包括冻结伊朗中央银行资产，终止购买伊朗的石油。早些时候，国际原子能机构发表报告说，伊朗有可能在秘密发展核武器。中国外交部23号表示反对对伊朗实施单方面的制裁。对此，美国纽约城市大学政治学教授夏明认为，冷战结束后，美国和西方社会面临的最大挑战来自中国和伊朗，他们同样受到美国和西方的孤立，所以中国的政策是可以预见的。
中国跟伊朗呢，基本上面临着西方的政治、经济、文化的挑战，所以呢，这两个国家呢，在那个国际舞台上呢，那么基本上呢，都是有一种协调，那么也都是相互在支持。那么，所以我们看到的就是说，中国呢。跟伊朗呢，两个国家呢，就是说协调的也非常多。那么再就是能源呢，再就是军火各方面呢，在国际舞台上呢，都有很多的合作。
美联社23号也报道，自2006年以来，联合国对伊朗施加了四轮制裁，但伊朗的能源出口使伊朗没有因被制裁受到严重损害。法新社则说，中国支持伊朗从伊朗购买大量的石油，同时中国也是伊朗最大的交易伙伴，两国间的贸易总额达300亿美元。美国之音报道，据中国海关资料，今年伊朗可能成为中国第二大原油供应国。不过伊朗对新一轮的制裁表示不屑，以色列和华盛顿表示，在其他努力无效的情况下，不排除军事打击。令人费解的是，中国国防大学教授、海军少将张召忠说，中国不惜三次世界大战保伊朗。
张召忠说这种就不惜那个就是打一场第三世界那个大战呢，那么我觉得就完全为了自己国内的就是一个政治的需要，从某种程度上说，通过这种就是那个完全是无稽之谈呢，来给自己壮胆。
夏明教授分析指出，目前美国和西方社会可能对伊朗采取茉莉花革命的模式，类似走利比亚那样的路。从利比亚模式看，北约不可能在伊朗卷入大规模的军事行动，更不可能掀起一场新的战争。实际上，一位驻德黑兰不愿透露姓名的高级欧洲外交官表示，伊朗政府实际上非常担心遭到军事打击。分析家也说，普通民众已经不太崇拜他们的领导人。但是夏明教授表示，中共政府自己面临的危机比伊朗要大得多。中共政府不仅面临东南亚、南中国海、南亚各国的诸多挑战，也面临美国在人民币汇率、出口、人权等问题上的压力，同时也面临国内问题的压力。
中国呢，面对着美国的压力，同时它国内的就是那个目前的压力呢也很大。那么尤其我们看到，从民间的社会上的，包括对中国政府的进行挑战和反抗的这个力量呢，也在成长。那么所以呢，中国政府呢，那么确确实实面对着他在权力交接班的那个十八大要到来，那么他的在外交上呢，那么恐怕呢，那么会发出一些比较强硬的这个就是声音。一方面是回应美国的这个压力，另一方面呢，他也是为了满足国内的就是民族主义的这批人的这个一个需求。
俄罗斯则是伊朗的另一个盟友，对伊朗的政策跟中国相似。新唐人记者陈汉、宋峰、郭靖采访报道。
Well, it just gets better and better, everybody. Here you go, some more stuff. I hope the other one works out okay. I tried to blow up the writing for y'all so y'all could read it. Best I can do, and I hope I'm going slow enough with this. It does what it wants to. Once I go to recording it, it'll either speed up or slow down. So I don't know. But anyway, much love, heads up, God bless everybody, because we sure need it. Here's your one more clip. Still don't tell us nothing, but it's another clip. It was 3 hours ago, according to this page, but probably more like six. But anyway, there you go, folks. That's the best I can do until something comes out. That's all I got. Much love.